pieces and see what God can do with a broken vessel. And of course, you remember it's not the vessel that counts. It's what's or who's in that vessel. And when you've given your life to oh, I love these young people here. Oh, you look so good. I love you. Love you, love you, love you, love you. Come to Romania. We need you. But you know, these young people, full of life, full of life. Oh, when I gave my heart to Jesus at 17, almost 18 years of age, you know, I didn't do it halfway. I gave it all. I was radicalized for Jesus. And I never missed a meal, obviously. The Lord has been faithful. What shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? Dear saints, God is for you. The life that God has for you is a life of power, a life of significance, a life that will change the world in some way. And your life, at the end of your life, you can say like the Apostle Paul, I fought a good fight. You want something easy? Don't come this way. You want something easy?
Go some other place.
But if you want a life of significance, of power, fighting a good faith, fight a faith. The Apostle Paul said, I've fought a good fight, I've kept the faith, and now I'm out of here. And Jesus on the cross, he says, Father, I did what I was supposed to do, and it is finished. It is accomplished. And now I also give my spirit to you. And today is a day of dedication, a rededication, with no excuses, with no compromise, wholeheartedly, 100%, not 99 and 99 100% pure. No, all of it. I will give all to you. And I close with this magnificent moment of the prophet Isaiah. There's one day I was in the temple and I saw the Lord. I saw him high. I saw him lifted up. The train filling the temple. This train is filling the temple here this morning. Can you sense his presence? Can you know that he is here? He is working. He is speaking. He is pleading. I beseech you, brother, don't waste the one life you have. Don't let it go to nothing. Let it count for eternity. And I saw the Lord. I saw him high, lifted up. The train filled the temple. And I saw the angels with the coals of fire. What were they for? They were for the forgiveness of sin. You can leave this morning knowing you're right with God. Your past is forgiven. It's purged with a call from off the altar. It exists no more against you. You are free. You are whole again. And then that call touched his lips. The things that he had said, spoken against God, against others, against himself. And most of our bad language is against ourselves. I can't. I'm not good enough. Oh, cut it out. Those who depend on you. Depend on the God in whom you believe. And when he had gone through that process, it was time for God to issue his want and his call. Who will go for us? Whom can I send? And that Spirit of God is working here this morning. And that same question that he asked Isaiah hundreds of years ago, he's asking for this generation, this people of God, this morning here in Ashland. Does God know we're here? Yes, he does. How do I know that? Because he is here present with us. And he is speaking. He is speaking to our hearts. Have you heard his voice? Not my voice, have you heard his voice? Maybe riding on my voice. And he's saying the same thing. Whom can I send? Who will go? And Isaiah, in the power and the majesty of that moment, I can see him lift one hand and said, here am I, Lord. And then he lifted the other one and he said, Lord, send me. Is there anyone here? Oh, I know you're here. Is there anyone here with me can say, here am I, Lord? Can you lift your hand with me and say, here am I? I see you way in the back. Yep. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, my. Can you lift the other one and say, send me, Lord? Send me. Doesn't have to be Romania. Send me. Oh, follow those hands and stay to your feet. Follow those hands and stay to your feet. And if you didn't raise your hand and you want to stay to your feet, stand up anyway. Stand up anyway.